don't need another cock on the sea. But what we need is a special word that will burn within our heart and give us direction from above.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Oh, we just thank you today. We're so grateful, Father, as we come to you this evening. Father, we thank you for all your many blessings. Father, we don't take it for granted, for you have been good to us. And we say thank you. We lift our voices, Father, in our hearts this evening. In unity, Lord. So we come together. We come before you with gratitude for this day that you have given unto us, Lord. We're so grateful for your blessings, Father. We thank you. Thank you, Father, for the ways that you have provided for us. Thank you for protecting us throughout today, Father. We're grateful. And Father, we thank you for guiding us and ordering our steps today. We praise your name, Father. We're so grateful. Again, you are the source of all of our resources. Father, you are the source. You are our source, our strength. And you are our refuge. So as we come to you this evening, Father, we thank you that we can be on one accord, that we can come together, two or three gathered together in your name. You said that you will be in the midst of them, Father. So we thank you for being here with us even right now. We thank you for your presence this evening, Father. We thank you for truly, truly being with us, Lord. For you said that I am with you always. You said, lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the world. Father, we thank you for that today. Many times we feel that we might be facing things alone. But we thank you for your reminders, for your promises, for your word, Father, that lets us know that we are not alone. Thank you for that today, Father. We're so grateful. And so, Father, we come before you this evening, and we're reminded of the power of your power, Father, and the importance of your word. And so your word is life to us, Lord. It is our daily bread. Hallelujah. Understanding that we just come off the deliverance fast, Father, but your word is our daily bread. So this is something that we continually receive from you every single day. Just as we cannot live without physical sustenance, we cannot live without the spiritual nourishment that comes from your word, Lord. But Father, we ask that you would speak to us tonight, speak to our hearts, speak to our ears. Father, let us hear what you're saying today. Our ears are attuned to your voice, and our hearts are open to receive what you have to say to us, Father. We thank you for touching our hearts. As David said, create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us. So, Father, in this moment, we bring before you the things that we may have been holding on to all day long, those burdens, those concerns that weigh heavy on our hearts. So, Father, we thank you that we can bring those concerns before you, that we can bring those cares, those burdens before you, Lord. Because many of us have faced challenges throughout today. We've faced obstacles throughout today, Father. And we are in need of your guidance and your wisdom. We are in need of a word from you, Lord, that will calm the storms within us. A word that will provide clarity, hallelujah, in the midst of confusion. And a word that will give us the strength to continue pressing forward. So, Lord, we ask that you would speak that word to us today. Speak to our hearts, Lord. Speak to our situations. Speak to our souls, Lord. We need a word from you, and we trust that you will provide that word, Father. We're grateful today. And Father, we thank you as we understand that you're doing a great work in us, Father. That you have great plans in store for us, your children, Father. So we thank you that we know to stay in this secret place. For we dwell here, Father. For this is the place that you have told us to be in consistently and continuously. Father, you told us to pray without ceasing. So we thank you that we come to this time of prayer together, Father, that we're praying without ceasing. And we're declaring that we will keep the fire burning. Hallelujah. The fire that you have ignited within us, the passion for your word, Lord. And the desire to seek your face. And Father, we're committed to walk in your ways. Father, this fire will not go out. We refuse to let the flames of our devotion dwindle. Instead, we will stoke the fire. We will feed it with your word, Lord. Hallelujah. And fan it with our prayers. Just as the priest did in the Old Testament, Father, as they were instructed to keep the fire on the altar burning, we commit to keeping the fire of our faith burning strong. But we thank you today, Father. We declare that no circumstance, hallelujah, no trial, no challenge will be able to extinguish the fire that burns within us. We will keep the fire burning. Yes, Lord, we will. And we thank you today, Father. And we understand that keeping the fire burning requires intentionality and diligence. It requires us to stay connected to you, Lord, and to remain in constant communication with you, and to immerse ourselves in your word, Lord. Hallelujah. And so we thank you, Father. We ask you for your help this evening as we are diligently seeking you, Father. And so, Father, we thank you that we have a desire to study your word. We have a desire to read your word. We have a desire to not only get it in our heads, but get it in our hearts. Because David said, thy word have I hid in my heart, not in my head, but in my heart, that I might not sin against thee. And so this evening, Father, we ask that you would help us to remain steadfast in our pursuit of you, Lord, that we will pursue you above all, above everything else. Father, we will seek ye first your kingdom and your righteousness. Help us to prioritize our time with you, Lord, to seek you first in all that we do, and to keep our hearts and minds focused on you. Father, don't let us lean to the left or to the right, Father, but let us truly focus on you. So thank you today, Father. Thank you for the flames of passion within us. Thank you for stirring our hearts, Lord. Hallelujah. And thank you for a deep hunger for your presence. We praise you, Father. We give you all the glory today. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. Thank you for restoring our joy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for breathing new life into us, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you for breathing new life into us, Father. Thank you for renewing our strength and reigniting our passion for you, Lord. And we thank you that you are the one who began a good work in us. You are the one, Lord, and you will be faithful to complete it. Hallelujah. We thank you, Father. We praise you, Father. We thank you for your wisdom and your direction. Thank you, Father, that we're never without guidance, Father. We're never without your leading, Father. We thank you for giving us the path that we should take. For your word is a lamp unto our feet and a light to our path. And so we thank you for that today, Father. We thank you that we know that we are to trust you in all of our ways. That's your word, Father. And it says that you will direct our path. And many times we get off the path because we didn't trust you in all of our ways. We lean to our own understandings. But today, Father, we say that we trust you and we will not lean to our own understanding. But in all our ways, we will acknowledge you, Lord. And we thank you for leading us and directing our path. We thank you, Father. We submit our plans to you, Lord. We submit our dreams to you and our desires to you, Lord. And we thank you what your word says, that if we delight ourselves in you, you will give us the desires of our heart. And so, Father, this evening, let us sincerely delight ourselves in you. Let us genuinely delight ourselves in you, to seek your will above our will, to seek your way above our way. For if we delight ourselves in you, you will give us the desires of our heart. Father, we put you first, your will first, Father, your way first. And so whatever that is, Father, we surrender. Surrender to your word today. We surrender to your will today. And we praise you. Thank you for clarity, Lord. Thank you for giving us the clarity we need to move forward in faith. So we're able to strip off the old man, strip off the old way, Father, that you have given us clarity so that we can move forward in faith, that we're no longer bound, that we're no longer carrying all of the weights, all of the heaviness, but we're able to move forward freely because you have given us clarity. Oh God, we thank you for that today. Grateful that you have clarified some things in our lives, Father. We thank you, for you're not the author of confusion. And so we praise you for that today. Father, we thank you that we can bring everything to you and that you hear us and you answer us. For you told us to cast all of our cares upon you, for you cared for us. And so that means whatever is concerning us concerns you, Lord. And so, Father, even as we are experiencing in this world chaos and unpredictability, a lot of things that are occurring, Father, we need your peace. In the midst of all of this, we need your peace today. We need your word of peace, Lord. Peace that surpasses all understanding and that will guard our hearts and our minds in Christ Jesus. And so, Father, we ask for your peace to settle us as your children. Settle us. Settle over us even now in the name of Jesus. Settle us. Settle over us like a blanket. And let your peace calm our fears. Ease our anxieties and fill us with the assurance that you are in control. Even though it doesn't necessarily look that way, Father, that when it looks like it's not in your control, that you are sovereign, that you are in control. And so, Father, let us trust you and know that in the end, we win. And so no matter what comes, come what may, we're still in your hands, Lord. Nothing and no one can pluck us out of your hand. Father, we thank you for that today, for we are truly more than conquerors in Christ Jesus. And so we praise you, Father. We give you glory today. We give you honor. It's amazing to be in your hand. It's such a wonderful thing to know that you have us and nothing can defeat. Because if you be for us, if God be for us, who can be against us? And so, Father, we thank you that we can grab hold of this promise today, that we understand that we're part of a kingdom, and the kingdom is the kingdom of light. Father, we thank you that we have truly, truly been given everything we need to be victorious. Oh God, we thank you. Let us truly stay connected to what you have given unto us. Father, let us take your promises and appropriate them in our lives, for they are yes and amen. And so we have the necessary tools. And so Father, let us begin to tap into the faith that you have given unto us, Father, the measure of faith, each one of us. And so let us take that measure of faith, Father, and let us take your word that says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, Father. So we ask even now that you would increase our faith through us hearing your word, that we're applying your word, that we hear your word and we take your word and apply your word as our faith increases. because without faith, Father, we understand that it's impossible to please you. And so faith is about our beliefs. It's about what we believe, Father. So today, Father, we believe what your word says. Your word says, greater is he that is in us than he that is in the world. It doesn't matter what's going on in the world. Greater is he that is in us. And so we thank you, Father, for Jesus said that you in this world, you will have trouble. But don't worry, because he have overcome the world. And so, Father, we thank you today. We praise your name. Thank you for your faithfulness, Lord. Thank you for your love. Thank you for the assurance that you are with us every step of the way. Hallelujah. And we thank you for the word you will speak to us this evening, Father, as we meditate, as we listen, as we are inclined, as we're listening to what the Spirit is saying to us. And so we thank you, Father, for the word that you will speak to us. A word that will strengthen us, a word that will guide us, a word that will keep us rooted in your will, Lord. And so we thank you today. Thank you for giving us another chance to keep the fire burning. And so, Father, forgive us for slacking. Forgive us for anything that we may have said or done today that caused the fire to dwindle. But not go out, Father. Thank you for your mercy to where we may have slacked a little today, Father. So we ask for forgiveness. Let us pick back up and start again, Father. Let us truly dust our feet off and get back in and do our part. And so we thank you for that, Father, for another chance. For you said if we confess our sins, you're faithful and just to forgive us of our sin and to cleanse us from all wickedness, all unrighteousness. So we thank you for that today. We praise your name. We will keep the fire burning. We will hold on to your promises. And we will trust that you are working all things together for our good. And we thank you, Lord. Thank you for purpose. Thank you for the assignment that you've given each one of us. Let us truly do our part, Father, for your glory, for your kingdom. And we thank you today, Father. We praise you. Keep us safe throughout the evening. Let us hear you this evening, Father. And let us apply what you speak to us. And we thank you that it's landing on good ground. Yes, it's on good ground, Father, and we thank you. Our hearts are ready to receive what you're speaking. We love you, Lord. Give us rest. Let us continue to dream. Let us continue to go forth, Father. Let us continue to have spiritual downloads, revelation of what you've given unto us, Father. And we praise you. This great work you started, continue, Father, all the way to completion. And we bless your holy name. We thank you until we meet again, Father. We thank you and we praise you. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. We say hallelujah and amen.